The defense rested its case today in the federal trial of five current and former police officers. The officers are accused of the fatal shooting of a man, burning his body, and covering up the incident after Hurricane Katrina. WDSU reporter Gina Swanson was at federal court today. She tells us why today's proceedings were a bit unusual. Gina?
Scott, out of the ordinary to say the least, Judge Lance Afric actually had to halt testimony briefly this morning after an NOP detective said that a former colleague confessed to lying to the grand jury about the case. Detective Catherine Beckett said the confession happened about 2 months ago during lunch with a former NOPD sergeant, Aaron Riley. Now, Riley and one of the defendants in the case, Robert Italiano, were known not to like each other because of a previous dispute. In testimony, Beckett said that Riley admitted to lying to the grand jury about Italiano's role in the case. At that point, Judge Afric stopped the testimony. He asked the jury to leave the courtroom and advised Riley of her rights, because if this was information that she knew and didn't tell anybody, this could possibly be a violation of the law. When court resumed this afternoon, Catherine Beckett decided not to return to the witness stand, Scott.
And Gina, the final defendant, Travis McCabe, took the stand today. Anything relevant that he had to say?
You know, McCabe is one of the officers accused of fabricating the police reports to cover up the shooting of Henry Glover. He's also accused of lying to federal agents. Looking back on the police report, he said it is, quote, a shoddy piece of work. But he also said, looking back on the shooting, that there should have been some obvious connections. But he said obvious connections between Officer Warren firing his weapon and Henry Glover's body. But he insists that he did not cover anything up, Scott.
All right, Gina Swanson, live in the news center tonight at 5. Gina will tell us what's next in this case and a look at how the rest of the trial will unfold. Checking the top stories across America today, a major announcement from NASA, which